Hello, good morning. Welcome back to Vlogmas. This is my impromptu Vlogmas where I'm pretending that I'm doing Vlogmas, but it's really just my own version where I upload holiday videos and vlogs and DIYs and fun things. I can't remember. December 5th, Thursday. I can't believe it's Thursday. So I'm gonna try and take you guys along with my day, really my morning, because I start work every day at 1. So I wake up early and then I kind of start my day from there, eat breakfast, which I already did. Now I'm working on editing to get this video up today. It's an easier video to edit. It is my mystery sample bag unbagging. A little sped up of what, you know, I look like when I'm editing, which is this right here. I woke up like this. I hope you all look like me when you wake up. Fresh as a daisy. I really need to wash my hair. I put a banana hair mask in the other day and slept in it, and I really need to wash out. But showering and brushing my hair and everything, it takes so long. So maybe I will do that tonight and then just throw my hair up in a bun. I have to go out today. I have to go do an order pickup. I've been doing like tons of order pickups. I have an order pickup at Route 21. I have to go pick up my new phone. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I have to go pick it up at Best Buy. So excited. So maybe I'll do a separate video on my new phone. And what else? I wanted to go to Kirkland's and do a video there, but I don't know if I'll do that today. I need to make a list. So I want to first things first, finish up this video. This is what my view looks like. I'm just on my laptop. This MacBook is from 2011 or 2010. I got it when I graduated college, so I've had this thing for, oh my gosh, 8 years, which is crazy. And it's definitely showing its age, but honestly, who wants to pay $1,000 for a new MacBook? That's why I've held it off. My husband's like, just buy a new one. I'm like, but I don't want to spend $1,000, so I just stick with this one. Bag. He likes to chew on plastic and like leave holes in things. Doesn't he look like a squirrel? Hi, Oliver! Hi! Hi, kid! Get the tripod. The kitties are sleeping, or they were, then I opened the door, but I always feel better when they're sleeping when I go out, just because I know they're like relaxing, and yeah, I don't know, cat mom. I'm gonna go into the mall right now, go to Rue 21, and then I'm gonna go to Bath & Body, because my Bath & Body that's closer by me, I got the fragrance mist, the Christmas ones, and when they were $4.95, and I bought 4 because they didn't have hot cocoa and cream. I went back and I got 2 Christmas cookies, so I exchanged 2, and I still have 2 more to exchange for hot cocoa and cream, but it was sold out at my store. It's like so popular. And I messaged them on Instagram and I was like, you guys need to make a hot cocoa and cream hand soap. And they were like, that's a great idea. I'm like, well, it's your best seller. Why wouldn't you? This is why, you guys, I worked in beauty, because I don't know, if you were on Bath & Body Works and you had like a best seller for Christmas, wouldn't you like make it in every scent? You would make it in a hand soap, a hand sanitizer, a spray, a room spray, like make it in every form, because it will sell out. I don't know, that's just my thought. And next year they'll come out with the hot cocoa and cream hand soap, and I will buy tons of them because it's my favorite scent. So I just had gotten Vanilla Bean Noel, just as like to get the $4.95 price and then just to exchange them. That's what the lady told me to do. So hopefully they have them here. Let's go and do some mall shopping.
Oh, I didn't even realize this, but right where I walked in, Rue 21 is right there. How awesome is that? I don't think I've ever been inside this store. But they have some cute stuff. Oh my god, how cute is that?
But I love the jagged
edge. How cute are these overalls? I love overalls. And then they have some cute like pullovers. These are on sale for only $7. The guy is like spraying a fragrance and I was like coughing because it's so strong, but I know we used to do that at Hollister to make the store smell good, but this fragrance doesn't smell that good. They have some cute sunglasses. These are fun. This store kind of reminds me of like PacSun. Some like little clearance items. Conveniently enough, Bath & Body Works is right here. And then they have $3 hand soaps today, and they also have a 20% off coupon, so I might pick up a couple of those. Let's see if they have hot cocoa and cream. Look what I found. Lots of them. This is supposed to be really good too. Santa's Blueberry Shortbread. I have to smell that one. This one, you guys, smells so good. Lemon buttercream. The packaging is really cute this year on like the little cartoon looking ones. So precious. Okay, guys, got my stuff. Does anyone remember when the mall was like bustling? This mall though was super quiet. It's not the bigger mall in my area, so I like come here because it's quiet. But I'm like, how do these stores survive? I wonder. But now I'm gonna go to Best Buy. That is my next stop. Okay guys, I just got home and I'm falling. I'm about to start work for the day. It is so dark over here. So I didn't bring you guys into Best Buy because it was just like I was waiting in line. There really wasn't much to see at all. But I did get my new phone and this is gonna be a whole separate video. I won't show you guys what I got. Well, I will show you the pop socket I got because it's super cute, but I want to do a whole separate video about my new phone. I'm so excited. So this is the pop socket I got, and I was deciding between a couple, but I like this one because it goes with the phone case that I got from Velvet Caviar. And this one is called Speckle Black, in case you guys are interested. It has that like chunky glitter on it. I love my pop socket, cannot live without it. From Bath & Body, I did get one of the lemon buttercream foaming hand soaps. I only got one with a 20% off and $3 because I figure I'm gonna get a bunch on clearance after Christmas, so I didn't want to go crazy because they're usually like $1.50 during the 75% off clearance. But this one smells amazing. I was showing you guys that at the store, and I exchanged the fragrance mists that I had purchased and finally got hot cocoa and cream. So you can see the second one's in there. This is one of the most amazing scents ever, and it is limited edition, so if you want one, make sure you grab it. I got this when it was $4.95, like I was telling you guys. So it's really pricey though. Regularly it's $15.50, which is crazy, so I would only get that on a sale. And then this was a random this was a little hand sanitizer I got last time I was there. This is gingerbread latte. So that's gonna be it for my vlog today. It was so much fun kind of hanging out with you guys, taking you along with my morning, and then taking you out shopping with me really quick and doing some order pickups. And I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I'm really enjoying doing vlogs in December, just like kind of a fun way for you guys to get to see more behind the scenes and hang out with me a little bit more besides just my regular videos. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next Vlogmas. Hey guys, so it is Thursday. Yes, Thursday. And I just got my hair done. That's why I look fancy. Oh my gosh, you guys, he did such a good job. So I didn't get a haircut because I just got one recently. Hopefully you can see it. He did a really good job. So what I got is a deep conditioning hair treatment, and I was like, maybe I should take you guys with me, but I couldn't really film it because my head was in the sink and then he was blow drying my hair. And also I had never been here before, so I didn't want to like whip out my camera. I did tell him I was a beauty blogger, but I was like, I'll just tell you guys about it after and show you the result. You guys know like what my hair looks like on the reg. So basically I got a deep conditioning hair treatment called, the brand or whatever hair brand is called Milbon. And I had heard about it from
a guy I got my haircut from about 2 months ago. And this is another funny story. So he's like, your hair's really tangled, which it is, especially on this side. When you get blonde color or bleach, like I got over a year ago, I got the blonde in my hair. You guys know when I went like all blonde. It's still a lot there. And I love it still. I love it. And I haven't even gotten it touched up. But it makes your hair really tangly because it's dry and then it gets tangled and then it's hard to brush through your hair and then your hair starts falling out because you're brushing out so much hair. And it was kind of freaking me out because my hair would be so tangled and I was scared. I was like, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm losing so much hair. Like I'm not gonna have thick hair anymore because my hair has always been really thick. And I still have really thick hair, but I just feel like I was losing so much from the tangles. So, and it was really hard for me to brush through, even with, I would put in like globs, like tons and tons of, I would do conditioners, deep conditioners. I would put in the detangling spray. I've tried tons of detangling sprays and I would spray, like saturate the hair. But I was like, you know what? The guy told me about the treatment and I was like, he was kind of being annoying about it and just like too much. And I was like, no, it's okay. Like I'll think about it. Thought about it the past couple months. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to try and find a salon that's closer to me that does that deep conditioning treatment. So I looked up like the salon locator and I found a salon that's beautiful right by me, like 10 minutes away. The salon is so nice. It's like all open windows. You do the deep conditioning treatment there. And I was like, you know what? I just have to do it to make brushing my hair easier on myself and also just hopefully so I'm not losing as much hair. So I thought it was going to be like this hour long process because I feel like everything with hair is always so long. And he did it. It was three steps, and Milbon is a Japanese brand, and apparently they're very like ahead of times, and they're really good with like research and development, and they're very like cutting edge. And it's not a keratin, it's not chemical or anything like that. It's literally a deep conditioning three-step treatment. And he put it in my hair. That took about 10 minutes. And he brought me to the chair to blow dry. And I was like, wait, that's it? And he was like, yeah. He's like, it's super quick. And I was like, what? I was like, I thought I was going to be here for like an hour doing like all those three steps. He was like, no, it's really quick. He was very nice. And then he blow dried my hair. And I'm going to go to the post office now. And then I have to go to a very, very far Target that I didn't order pickup for. It's like really far, but it was the only store that had a Christmas thing. I got three of them, so I'm gonna go over there because today they sent me a text. It's like, today is the last day that you can pick up your order. And I was like, oh crap, so I have to go there. So this is a really long vlog / talking thing, but whatever, it's Vlogmas. All right, so let's go in to wherever I have to.
You guys, look at this. I'm at Target and they have these little baby butter palettes. We have that one, deeper one. Oh, this is a bronzer one. Ooh, this has a highlighter, a blush, and a bronzer. This is cute. Cute. And then they have these. This is from a brand called Kai, and they're chocolate scented. So they look like a chocolate bar palette. There's three of them. It's cool. It's way nicer than ours. I have one in my town, but this is in like a really fancy town, so that explains it. But it looks bigger and it's a lot more neat and just overall nicer. I'll kind of show you guys like an overview. Target, which is popular in my area. So this is like the clothes. And then, ooh, the food section is even really nice. I would come here more often. It's just really far from where I live. Ooh, look at this. We got these little baby wet brush. Cute. They have my bread. Do you have my English muffins? Nope. These are the best chips, guys, in the whole world. I love them. Late July, sea salt, and lime. I'm obsessed, and they're cheaper here at Target than they are at Stop and Shop. They have plain ones too, which are honestly so good as well. I'm just obsessed with lime, but get these. There's the I'm laughing because there's an old couple fighting in the other aisle and she's She's like, get out of that aisle. And then he said something. She goes, what are you saying? I'm like, oh my gosh, that's going to be wipes. That's going to be me and Nick when we're old. Guaranteed. I just layered this one on top of it for now because I like layering things and it just adds a little bit of dimension to the couch. So this is the Opal House blanket and it's so cute. I'm just going to kind of go like that so you can see all the pom-poms. It's really cute. I can't wait to put the other one in the bedroom. The other day I watched a documentary on YouTube and it was so good. So if you're my age, 30, 29, millennial, whatever, of 31, 32, you'll appreciate this. So it used to be paid, but then they made it free. It's produced by Lance Bass, and it is like the Lou Pearlman story. And if you are an NSYNC fan, or you're my age, you probably know about Lou Pearlman. I was like a hardcore NSYNC fan. He managed NSYNC and the Backstreet Boys in like the beginning of their career, like 99, 98, 99, when they first came on the scene. And it's all about him and his relationship with NSYNC and how he really just like swindled them and robbed them, and then also how he, you know, swindled all these people out of millions of dollars and then he went to jail. And it's just really, really interesting to watch, especially if you're my age and you grew up loving NSYNC or the Backstreet Boys, and then you see that and you're like, whoa, like this was happening. And it's just so weird. They even said at one point they were making millions in album sales and they only got a salary of $34 a day. And then he also managed LFO. So if you girls know LFO, Summer Girls, I like girls that wear Abercrombie and Fitch. He managed that band too. And he just like screwed with everyone, every band he worked with. And it's just wild. Like, you have to watch it. Such a good documentary. I think there's actually another one coming out on NBC about Lou Pearlman. So it's really kind of like all coming out, or it's been out, but like it's all kind of debuting now. And it's like a hot topic. Check it out. It's super interesting. I really enjoyed, but it was interesting to watch. Okay guys, so I realized I did not show you what I got for Black Friday, so let's do that now. I have even a box I didn't open. So I got this case from Velvet Caviar for my new phone. It is so cute. It has stars and moons on it, and they're gold and silver, and they're really cute. Isn't this case so cute? Looking for a new case for my phone, and I saw this one. I was like, okay, this is perfect because it's still clear and you can see the color of the phone because it's so cool. I didn't want to hide it, but then you have these stars, which I absolutely love. And then you can see a theme here, more stars. This I got from Poshmark. It's brand new at Tags. It's this Kate Spade wristlet with stars on it. This they don't make anymore. That's why I got it on Poshmark, and I love wristlets when I'm out at the store. I just throw my phone in here and cards and some cash, and then I'm good because I do not like carrying around a bag. I don't know, is that just me? I hate bringing a bag into the store. I hate wearing a coat in the store. This coat is one that I've been wanting for a while now. I originally saw it, you can't really see, this is a horrible representation of it. It's from J. Crew Factory. This is their, what's the name of it? There's a specific name for it. It's like, I think it's Veil Parka. I'll show you guys what it looks like. But I saw Joanna Gaines wearing this in gray. I did want the gray, but it was sold out. Pink is my next favorite color. Okay, so here's what it looks like. Really cute. I hope this size is good. This is the 6. I think it's perfect for sweaters. I hope it's not too big because I don't want it to be too big. Like, I feel like down here it does look a little big, so I'm wondering if I should exchange it for the 4. I do have a J. Crew Factory around where I live, so I can go to the store. It's not far. I really like the color. I think the color is super cute. Probably wouldn't button it up to the top. I just kind of leave it like this and then do this as the last button. I can't tell if it looks too big, but I always have to close my closet because Gizzy jumps up there, and then I have these lights and I don't want him to step on that and it to fall off the wall. So sorry, I look crazy right now, like literally morning self. Guys, I don't know. I swear you guys, I got presents for other people. I just went a little crazy for myself because everything was such a good sale and they were things that I wanted. So these are from Aerie. These are the Spanx dupe leggings. So they're originally $54.95. I think I got them for $27. I think they were like $60 off in free shipping. And these are small. Holy moly. I think these are going to be way too small. They didn't have the large. I always size up in leggings because I like to be comfortable. I don't want to feel like something is like sucking me in. So these are a dupe for the Spanx leather leggings. I think I said that, and everyone was raving about these. They are really nice quality. They're called the Crackle. That's it. Crackle legging. You can see it's a little crackle. Has the nice thick waistband, but I think I'm gonna have to exchange these at the store for one size up because I don't know, this looks really small up here. So these have tons of awesome reviews. I saw people saying they were a great dupe and I didn't want to pay for the Spanx. So I would try these on for you, but I just feel like they're gonna be a little too small on the waist. So I'm going to exchange these. Hey guys, I put my ring light on because I have it over here so you guys could see me. It is dark, it is nighttime. It is Saturday night and I filmed my BoxyCharm video, got that up super quick. I put up an Instagram video and I'm just waiting for Nick to get ready and then I have to change and we're gonna go to a Christmas light show really close to where we live, but it is gonna be both of our first times going and I'm so excited because I don't think we're gonna go see the tree in the city this year. So I thought this was like another second best option for us to do, and you could just stay in your car and you drive through the lights, and it was $22 for the car. And I think we're gonna actually go to Cheesecake Factory. We haven't been there in a while. We were thinking Grand Lux, but I'm like, maybe Cheesecake Factory. And what else? And yeah, that's it. I'm really excited. I feel like I got a lot done today. I made some ornaments. I make my own, well, I sound like so official. I make ornaments like on my Silhouette machine. And one of them is like a gift, so I don't want to show it on camera. The other one, I'll show you guys. So this is one of the ornaments I made today and I love it. I have to make one for myself, but I made this for a friend. It says, because someone we love is in heaven, there's a little bit of heaven inside our home. So, and then I just put these feathers that I got from the Dollar Tree in the back. The actual ornament is a flat ornament, so it's good if you like to do DIYs with your machine, your Silhouette machine. This took me a while because I kept messing it up and the letters were giving me some issues, but I really love the way it came out. I hope she likes it too. And the feathers in the back are supposed to just look like angel feathers basically, so it's just a really nice memorial ornament. And I just like making stuff for other people, just things like that I think are really special and unique and custom, and it's like something you can't buy in the store, and I love that. That's why I'm absolutely obsessed with my Silhouette machine. I'll have to kind of talk about it a little bit more, but it's seriously one of my favorite items that I have and one of my favorite gifts. It was a gift for my birthday. I told Nick, like, this is my birthday gift 2 years ago, so it technically was a gift, but I love it right now. These are from the Stars Above line from Target. And I'll have to, I don't know, I'll show you a better view of them. I've been wearing them for like 2 days. I have to wash them. So gross. But they are the coziest ever. They're called like brushed fleece pants or something. You need to have these in your life. They were on sale last week, so I got these. And I wish I would have got another color because everyone in the reviews was like, they're so soft, they're so cozy. And I was like, all right, I'm going to try these out. So I got, I thought I was going to need a bigger size, but I got a size small because I usually like my sweats to be pretty oversized. But these are a little more fitted, but there's still room. And the inside is this like insanely cozy fleece. And I love these pancakes. Fried mac and cheese bites.
These aren't bites.
What would you say they are? Dig in. Pork belly sliders.
That's me.
Living our best life at Cheesecake Factory. All right, here's what I got. Chicken Romano with angel hair pasta. And we got the orange chicken. Oh, it's blurry.
Wait. Right?
I got chocolate chip. What is it? Chocolate chip cookie dough.
Louder.
Chocolate chip cookie dough and cheesecake.
How is it?
It's really good. Minus the walnuts, but it's a, I just got my finger. The Dunkin' line right now, getting coffee. I just went out early and did shopping. I went to Walmart and Target and Dollar Tree because I needed boxes, wrapping paper. Oh my god, that's a really cute dog. Cute. Looks like a border collie. Oh, there's another dog. So cute. So I got wrapping paper. I'll show you guys what I got. Some presents, and I'm still not done. You guys, so busy, so busy. I need to set up my new phone. Hi, can I have a medium of the holiday eggnog?
Okay.
Ice, please.
Okay.
And can I please have just a medium black iced coffee?
Okay.
And do you have the chocolate chip muffin? Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
All right, come on, you're 10:44.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Safe to drive with this on. Unstabilized. Don't do this. I need to get one of those vlogging stands. I used to have one, but I think it broke. I'm at the Dunkin' drive-thru because I did not want to go in the inside because it's so much easier going through the drive-thru, but we only have like a couple drive-thrus, so I came a little bit slightly further to this one. Alright guys, I am doing some wrapping on my bed. I basically have my station set up here. So I got these scissors today from Walmart. They are awesome. They're just the Scotch brand. I was like, let me get a nice pair because I know I'm going to be doing a lot of cutting and wrapping. These tags are from like 3 years ago. I have a whole, like literally whole suitcase full of stuff. And I wish I would have taken some inventory before I went to the Dollar Tree today because I didn't realize that I had so many boxes. And I went to the Dollar Tree today and got a bunch of boxes. So I'm like, oh my gosh, I really did not need that many. Because I have so many from clearance from, I think it was like 2 years ago, and they've just been kind of away in storage. So I've been going through those, and like I said, I got a bunch of stuff from Dollar Tree today that I really didn't need. But I did get some wrapping paper today from Walmart, so I'll show you guys. I really like the set that I got. It has four rolls, and they're really cute. Very like red and green and just super Christmassy, which is what I want. This is the roll I'm using right now. I thought it was just so cute because it has a really nice Christmas tree on it. And then this is like a little tartan plaid, which I also thought was cute. This one looks like just a Santa silhouette. And then this one says season's greetings with a really pretty wreath. So this one was my favorite out of all the ones I saw. Some of them I would only like one roll or two rolls, but this one I liked majority, like all the rolls. So I was like, okay, my wrapping pile. I just did this one. I thought it was really cute. These tags I also had from, I think, 2 years ago, and they're from Walmart. It's like this really big chunky tag with glitter that says Merry. I love these. And I just tied some twine. And I think the paper looks really cute. It kind of reminded me of like vintage paper, which is what I wanted. These bags I got on clearance from Forever 21 in like the summer, which is really funny, and I thought they were really cute. I think I paid like 25 cents for two of them, or each were 25 cents. I have another one back there, and then I have some stuff over there, but some stuff in here. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys. I'm also watching this really cute Christmas movie on Prime. It's called Christmas in Mississippi with Jonna Kramer, who I really like, and so far I really like it. Alright guys, it's 1 a.m. Here's the progress I made so far on present wrapping. How cute is this bag? By the way, I think I got this last year, and then my sister she used her Silhouette machine to make these mitten tags. So I just kept the one on from last year and rewrote out the name. But here's what we got so far. Also, these bags are like my favorite. I get these on clearance after Christmas for like 5-10 cents, and they just look like little lunch bags in Christmas form, and they're easy to just like stuff. And so I have a bunch of those. I think I have like literally 20 more of these bags for tonight. I feel good about what I got done. I'm gonna go to bed. It's like 1 in the morning. I'm gonna wake up around maybe 7:15, eat breakfast, work, and then I have a really fun event tomorrow with InStyle and JCPenney Salon. I'm so excited. I'll tell you guys more about that tomorrow. So I will see you guys tomorrow.